So what I was looking for when I was looking for colleges, engineering was really important to me, so I was looking at some of the big engineering schools. But the thing that attracted me to Harvard the most was that I had the opportunity to pursue engineering, but also within the liberal arts setting.
You have like this wealth of different concentrations, departments, definitely a lot of different things that you can learn, ranging from history and literature to computer science to even like folklore and mythology.
I definitely wanted to be able to also study history and English and those different things, and so Harvard definitely stood out in that way.
I didn't have like formal engineering experience from high school, so I was really looking for somewhere where engineering was something I could focus on, but there were other avenues to explore.
So I really love that the engineering school is actually pretty small here. That means that all of the students have a really great relationship with all of our professors. Our class sizes are quite small, and I would say I know all of my professors very well, and they know me not just in the classroom, but outside of the classroom. And I've had professors come and watch my squash matches because I play on the squash team here, and they take an interest in your personal life.
I would definitely consider CS for the community and the close-knit experiences that CS offers. I don't think you get that at a lot of bigger schools, and at a lot of smaller schools, you kind of lose the caliber of engineering that Harvard offers.
So Harvard Ventures is the student entrepreneurship group on campus.
I joined Harvard Student Agencies. It's a collection of student-run businesses.
So I was involved with Harvard Model United Nations.
I first found out about the Harvard Society of Black Scientists and Engineers when I was a freshman.
To be good at squash, you have to be really incredibly fit, and it's a very mental sport.
I joined the Harvard Radcliffe Orchestra my freshman year. There are actually something like four or five different orchestras on campus that you can play in.
Everybody here sort of has that busyness because of the fact that they enjoy doing everything that they're doing. I guess like what people say is, when you're having fun, you're no longer at work. And that's sort of like the mentality I think a lot of us have here.
I definitely like the fact that research-wise, there aren't really any departments. So even though I am applied math. If I wanted to, I could find a CS professor and do a thesis as long as it was applicable to applied math. I also like that a lot of the concentrations still allow for a good amount of flexibility.
I often find the coolest things in science occur at the intersection of multiple fields, and so that was what really interested me in bioengineering.
So something like applied math is a great example because you have people who are doing applied math in government, applied math in chemistry, applied math in physics. There are all these different connections that can be made, and it really doesn't help anyone if we just stay kind of in our own little corners and don't share that.
So our project was designing an atmospheric detector for molecules in the troposphere. So it was actually for a NASA project.
So with Whitesides, I was doing soft robotics research. And what we were doing was a little bit of like the biomaterials, seeing how we could create robots that could simulate the movement of, for instance, insectoids, octopus, definitely like those types of invertebrates. The building part was really fun, but I was also interested in how the actual robots work in terms of the artificial intelligence side.
For my senior thesis, I'm working on a drone project. Eventually, it could be used in hopefully the Amazon rainforest, actually, to collect air samples.
So my thesis is a soft robotic drug delivery device. It can be fully implanted on any tissues or organs within your body. Right now, we're envisioning putting it on the heart.
And we got to see a micro CT machine and image reconstruction, and we've been able to reconstruct our own. And so those things, not only do they make the learning experience much more fun, they also make the idea stick.
So I think I've learned really important skills through all of my classes that aren't just applicable in the classroom settings. I have learned how to code and different engineering skills. I'm trained on all the machines. I can use MATLAB. There are a lot of team building exercises. Once you actually go out, if you're a practicing engineer, you need to be able to communicate your ideas effectively.
I definitely have been well prepared at CS for the type of research that I want to go in.
With that sort of very much hands-on, problem-solving focused curriculum that they give us, I think that is something that's really invaluable going forward.
As you learn about C's, I hope that you get a sense of the genuine excitement that we all have for the future of the school. Our students ask big, consequential questions. They embrace and address important societal challenges. And beginning in fall 2020, you will study in one of the most advanced science and engineering facilities in the country. At C's, we see a convergence of amazing faculty and students, cutting-edge science, a commitment to excellence, and a thirst for exploring big ideas. If you're willing to roll up your sleeves to tackle real-world problems, to learn new skills, to collaborate with people with different perspectives, if you're looking to truly make a difference in the world, I hope you will consider joining us.